This is the last in our series of videos on tricks of the trade, ways to diagonalize matrices. In this video, we're going to look at how to use transposes, row sums, and column sums to find eigenvalues. So the idea about column sums is the following. Take a look at this matrix. You notice that each column adds up to 2. 1 plus 3 plus negative 2 makes 2. 4 plus negative 3 plus 1 is 2. Negative 1 plus 1 plus 2 is 2. So what happens if you multiply this matrix by 1, 1, 1? You get 1 plus 3 plus negative 2, 4 minus 3 plus 1, negative 1 plus 1 plus 2, and that is 2, 2, 2. So 1, 1, 1 was an eigenvector with eigenvalue 2. If the columns had all added up to 17, then 1, 1, 1 would have been an eigenvector with eigenvalue 17. Whenever all of the rows of a matrix have the same sum, then 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, however many ones you need, you know, n ones for an n by n matrix, that's always going to be an eigenvector, and whatever that sum is going to be an eigenvalue. So, for example, suppose we have the matrix 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. We've seen this matrix before, but the sum of the first row is 2, the sum of the second row is 2, the sum of the third row is 2. So all the rows add up to 2, and that means that 2 has to be an eigenvalue. And now we can use our other tricks to find the other eigenvalues. The trace is 0 plus 0 plus 0, so all the eigenvalues have to add up to 0. So 2 plus the other two eigenvalues is 0, so the other two eigenvalues have to add up to negative 2. The determinant is 2, so 2 times lambda 2 times lambda 3 is 2, so lambda 2 times lambda 3 has to be 1. And the only numbers that multiply to 1 and add to negative 2 are negative 1 and negative 1. So we have 2 is an eigenvalue with multiplicity 1. Negative 1 is an eigenvalue with algebraic multiplicity 2. Turns out to also have geometric multiplicity 2, but that's you have to do more work to figure that out. Okay. Now, I talked about transposes. A property of determinants is if you take the transpose of a matrix and then take its determinant, that's the same thing as the determinant of the original matrix. Because if you take the determinant of lambda times the identity minus the transpose matrix, well, that's the same thing as the determinant of lambda identity minus A transpose, because the identity transpose is just the identity. And that's going to be the determinant of lambda I minus A, because when you take the transpose of a matrix, you don't change the determinant. But this is the characteristic polynomial of A transpose. And this is the characteristic polynomial of A. So A and A transpose have the same characteristic polynomial. Well, that means they have to have the same eigenvalues. So the eigenvalues of A transpose are always the same as the eigenvalues of A. Now, the eigenvectors can be very different, but the eigenvalues are the same. So now, let's take a look at this matrix. You look at the rows and you say, oh, this row adds up to 4, and this row adds up to 1, and this row adds up to 1. It doesn't look like there's anything happening with the rows. But the columns all add up to the same thing. This column adds up to 2, this column adds up to 2, this column adds up to 2. Since the columns all add up to 2, well, the columns of M are the rows of M transpose. So all the rows of M transpose add up to 2. But that means that 2 has to be an eigenvalue of M transpose. Well, that means that 2 has to be an eigenvalue of M. The general principle is that if you ever have a situation where all of the columns of the matrix are have the same sum, then that sum is an eigenvalue. You can't write down the eigenvector. There's no simple formula for the eigenvector. But the common sum of the columns is an eigenvalue. Now, it often happens in probability that you're dealing with matrices that describe the probability of situation tomorrow as a function of the probability of what things are today. And you have that each column adds up to one. That's called a probability matrix. A probability matrix is a matrix where each entry is non-negative and the columns add up to one. By this principle, such matrices always have one as an eigenvalue. Okay, so let's combine all the tricks we've learned so far to figure out the eigenvalues of this big 5x5 matrix. The first thing we want to do is we want to partition it. It's block triangular, so we really only have to find the eigenvalues of A, and we have to find the eigenvalues of D. So let's do these one at a time. Let's look at A. Whoops, this is a minus 5. The trace of A is 0. The determinant of A is 5 times minus 5 minus 3 times minus 3, so that's negative 25 plus 9, so it's negative 16. So the eigenvalues of A have the property that they add up to 0, and their product is negative 16. So that means the eigenvalues of A have to be 4 and minus 4. And that means that the eigenvalues of M have to include 4 and minus 4. Now let's take a look at D. This column adds up to 3. This column adds up to 3. This column adds up to 3. So one of the eigenvalues is 3. These are eigenvalues 1 and 2, and this is going to be eigenvalue 3. Now the trace is 6. And that means that 3 plus the fourth eigenvalue plus the fifth eigenvalue has to be 6. So the fourth eigenvalue plus the fifth eigenvalue has to be 3. Now if you work out the determinant, you get that the determinant of D is also 6. That has to be 3 times lambda 4 times lambda 5. So lambda 4 times lambda 5 have to be 2. So what are two numbers that add up to 3 and whose product is 2? Well, 1 and 2. So there we have it. The eigenvalues of this big 5x5 matrix are 4, minus 4, 3, 1, and 2. Now, how do you find the eigenvectors? Well, if you find the eigenvectors of this piece, you pad them with zeros and you get an eigenvector of the whole thing. If you have the eigenvectors of this piece, you can't pad them with zeros to get eigenvectors of the whole thing. You have to take m minus 3 times the identity and row reduce it to figure out this eigenvector, m minus 1 times the identity and row reduce it to get this eigenvector, m minus 2 times the identity to get row reduce it to get this eigenvector. The tricks of the trade generally help a lot with finding eigenvalues, but once you got the eigenvalues, you still have to work to get the eigenvectors.